The new Scottish Premier League kicked off on Sky Sports with the clash of the teams who contested last season's Tennent Scottish Cup final, Hearts and Rangers. Rangers have spent big again this summer, nearly £25 million to be exact, but as they discovered last season, money doesn't guarantee success. Hearts had nine of the men who won the cup in their starting lineup, the two exceptions being fit again skipper Gary Locke and striker Jim Hamilton. By contrast, Rangers only featured four of their cup final side with new faces Arthur Newman, Giovanni van Bronckhorst and Rod Wallace in the starting lineup. The commentators, the former Rangers and Scotland striker Ali McCoist and Ian Crocker.
It's the first competitive match of the season on Sky Sports. After this, we've only got a couple of hundred to go. It's Rangers who get us off and running. Gattuso playing at right back because they've had to move Perini into a central defensive position with so many players suspended. And of course, Daniel Prodan not yet ready to play, and they're still chasing Colin Hendry of Blackburn. Rangers won 5-2 and 3-0 here last season. Such emphatic scorelines, unlikely this time, and an immediate free kick. Gattuso, well, it's taken him less than a minute, unsurprisingly, to get stuck in.
No, he's very unlucky there. There's nothing in that at all, Ian. He actually tries to pull out the challenge and ends up slipping. There was nothing malicious in that at all.
He's got a bit of a reputation for doing that, though, so maybe his reputation went before him.
I would have thought you'd probably got a point there, yeah.
This is Jim Hamilton, who top scored for Hearts last season with 15. Gary Naismith, challenged by Rod Wallace. Stevie Fulton, who must have been on the brink of the Scottish squad prior to the World Cup. Here's Neil McCann, another exciting youngster here at Tynecastle. Gary Naismith. And that one will be collected by the Finnish international keeper, Antti Niemi, who's probably under pressure from Lionel Charbonnier, once the French keeper, who was third choice at the World Cup, regains fitness. He's got a hamstring injury at the moment. We'll expect to see a few tackles flying in this encounter. Hearts beat Rangers in the Scottish Cup final, of course, in May, but couldn't beat them at all in the league. They took just only 1 point off them. They couldn't beat Celtic either, and that's got to end if Hearts are to end Glasgow's domination of the Scottish Championship. Rod Wallace to Jury. And chance here for Rangers. Gattuso trying to get involved again. And the free kick will go the way of Hearts.
Yeah, that's the one thing about McCann. When he gets the ball in one of these runs, he's very quick, and when he goes down, it doesn't take a lot to knock him over. Having said that, in his defence, it was a foul.
Just 22 years of age, Neil McCann. Ian Ferguson to the Swede Jonas Thurn. Craig Moore to Gattuso, the Italian back to the Australian in this multinational Rangers lineup. There's a Scot though, Ian Ferguson looking for Van Bronckhorst. Wallace, and he's got the legs on Naismith, but he hasn't got the cross, which might have been collected by Rousse, but David Weir was taking no chances. Gattuso, already getting booed by the Hearts fans. Van Bronckhorst sizing one up, but it trickles harmlessly wide.
It's amazing that happens, Ian, because it wasn't a good strike at all, but if you've one of the strikers, whether Gordon, Jury or Wallace coming in the back stick, having a wee gamble, they walk that into the net, you know. I mean, it's a poor shot, but if you've somebody gambling there, somebody can walk that into the net.
And you speak as a man who gambled in that position a few times. Hamilton's header, cleared by Craig Moore. Here's Moore again, Gattuso. Wallace, looking lively, looking for Jury. And he's got the free kick. Now's Rod Wallace. Been fouled by Stefano Salvatore.
Yeah, he was just a little bit late and caught him.
Yunus turn over the free kick for Rangers. Albert's well forward. That should be the keeper, Rousseys. Although he was under pressure, he's got the free kick for the challenge by Rod Wallace, who's about half the size of Rousseys.
I've got to see, that's got to be one of the biggest mismatches I've seen in a long time. There should have been only one winner there. And there you see Wallace using his weight there. Actually gets up pretty well and forces Rousseys to punch.
6'5" of Rousseys. Header from Moore. Jury leaves it for Wallace. David Weir, who was linked with a move to Rangers, gets stuck in. Here's McCann. He's got Stefan Adam in the middle, and it might come through to Stefan Adam. Oh, what a start for Hearts! And it's the Frenchman, Stefan Adam. Not bad for starters.
I told you, I said before the game, an interesting area, a very important area, was going to be the Rangers' right-hand side. And Gattuso misses the ball there. And McCann shows great pace. And it's not the greatest of balls, but it just comes behind. I think it was Moore, and it's not good. It's a good finish by Adam, there's no doubt about it. McCann gets in behind Gattuso. It's not a great cross. Should have been cleared. And he toe-pokes. I think it goes through his legs. Great start for Hearts, disaster for Rangers.
Well, Hearts, of
course... Yeah, it goes through his legs.
They got an early goal in the Scottish Cup final. A bit earlier than that, though.
It was.
Penalty spot.
It certainly was. I think it's always a great time to score a goal.
Here's Wallace, though, looking for an immediate response. And it'll be a Rangers throw. Stefan Adam, 12 goals last season, including one against Rangers, which turned out to be the winner in the cup final in May. Well, it's going very much according to plan from the Hearts' point of view. They couldn't have asked for more than that to kick off the new Scottish season. You can hear the reaction from the Tynecastle faithful. Gattuso. Jonas turn. Ferguson to Van Bronckhorst. And the challenge by Locke. Gattuso. Stevie Fulton looking for McCann, who's going to give Rangers a torrid time on this side. Can't quite get the better of Craig Moore on that occasion, but he's got the free kick.
He certainly looks as though he's up for it, McCann. Having said that, that wasn't a good decision by the referee. That wasn't a foul at all. But Hart's ploy certainly to get the ball to McCann as early as possible, because he can pose problems.
It's Fulton over the free kick. Set-piece expert in this situation for Hearts. Fulton's cross towards Hamilton. Didn't quite find the target. Hearts already leading Rangers. And they were tonked twice by them here in the league last season. 5-2 and 3-0 the scores. They managed to pick up a point on one trip to Ibrox, but lost the other encounter there, 3-1. Oh, and a chance here for Van Bronckhorst, a major model in the Hearts' defence.
That was certainly a lack of something in the Hearts' box, because I think he thought Richie left it for Rousseau, who wasn't coming. And having said that, the big goalkeeper did well to make a good save at the end of it. Yep, he definitely reacts well.
It's Albert with that trusty left foot to swing the corner in. And it's going to go for another one off David Weir. One of the few central defenders who have been linked with Rangers recently. Still chasing Colin Hendry.
Yeah, David Weir's another one with a great season last year, Ian, culminating making the World Cup squad. And it obviously made his, I think he made his first cap against France in the friendly over there when it was beaten 2-1, but he's certainly had a great season last year.
Albert has to trot over to the other side to swing this one in. Jury's header will drop wide. He was trying to claim another corner then, but it was never going to happen.
You always, the one thing you're guaranteed with George Albert's is quality from free kicks and corners, and that that shows you with a fine example.
Signed an extension to his contract, Gordon Jury. And could be one of the few Scots to make a regular appearance in the Rangers starting lineup this season. Adam, it took white ball for Hamilton, and it's ricocheting everywhere. Salvatore, the Austrian Thomas Flogel, meets the German Albert, and the Dutchman Van Bronckhorst, who comes away with it for Rangers. Now Gattuso. Rod Wallace ahead of him, but Richie saw it coming.
Good defender, Marichis. He's one of the best young players in the country, and he reads things very well.
Here's Jonas Turn. Rangers rocked by that early Stefan Adam goal. Ian Ferguson finds Van Bronckhorst. And here he and Albert, not quite on the same wavelength.
I must admit, it's quite bizarre really to think that the manager's come out with a statement that he's not happy with the fitness of some of his players right at the opening game of the season. But having said that, to be fair to him, he's signed a lot of players, and a lot of the lads have been playing in the World Cup and things like that. And Amato and Kinshelskis have just been signed and they're on the bench, so it'll be interesting to see how they develop.
Perini does the mopping up. Naimi targets Jury. Another firm header from the excellent Richie. Stevie Fulton stepping away from Jonas Turn. Weir. Oh, he's given that away to Jonas Turn, who has Wallace to his right, but he's gone inside. Van Bronckhorst to Jury. Jonas Turn fending off Fulton, and that'll be a Rangers corner kick.
He battles away here, just gets the break of the ball and gets a corner. Rangers seem to be pressing and coming into it a little bit more since they've lost the goal.
Craig Moore up from the back. Albert goes for the near post, where Ian Ferguson was waiting, but so too was Stevie Fulton. Albert again. The flick on from Jury. Nobody to latch onto. Tim Jeffries, who guided Hearts to Scottish Cup glory in May, needs to take the next step now, really, and perhaps the title could be coming to Tynecastle. They were in the race for a long time last season. Here's Adam, the ball over the top, catching outrageous, and his touch let him down and allowed Naimi to rescue, and Adam's going to be in trouble for putting his foot in on the keeper.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, we don't even need to see the replay. His touch did let him down. A little bit concerning again for Rangers, because Rino Gattuso playing in a position that's a little bit alien to him, played him onside, and he was definitely onside in my book. And he took the touch, and it was a very poor touch, and he forced him to show his studs. Here we see him, he breaks through here, bad touch there, and he goes out with his studs. Naimi, to his credit, was very, very brave and made a great save. Ah, that's dangerous here when you show your studs. Referee's always going to take a strict hand with that, and he books him quite rightly so. But more importantly, from Rangers' point of view, it's a little bit concerning, as I said earlier. Gattuso in an alien position and played Adam onside there, where the rest of the defence were pushed up.
Away by Gary Locke. Hugh Dallas, the man in charge then. First yellow card dished out to Stefan Adam. Hugh Dallas, who also officiated at the World Cup in the summer. France, Italy quarter-final, and Belgium, Mexico in the group stages. Marino Gattuso to the former Leeds and Southampton man, Rod Wallace. Turn. Ferguson, ambitious.
Well, that's the one thing about Ferguson, he's never frightened to have a shot. He has got a great shot, good strike on him, and that's always going wide, but he's prepared to have an attempt at goal anyway.
He's been linked with Aberdeen, this weekend, and it would be hard really to see a future for him in this new look Rangers, I guess.
Well, you'd be surprised. I mean, according to a few of the sources, some of the pre-season games, Ian Ferguson, one of the better players. So it'll be interesting to see what happens this year.
Oh,
certainly a good man to have in your team here.
Yeah, obviously you know him very, very well from your time there.
Yeah.
A Rangers veteran.
That was a late tackle, yeah.
Gattuso, ball touch, allowed Neil McCann in, and then turned, rescued it for Rangers. Here he is again, over 70 Swedish caps. Albert, took it down nicely. That was a typically fierce Albert's drive across the box.
That was a great move. That's probably the best move of the game so far. Tremendous ball from Turner. Albert takes it wonderfully in his chest and drives a great ball across. It needs any touch at all, not even from Wallace. You're hoping for anything there, a deflection off Emdy, and that could get in the net. That's a great ball.
But he hits it. He certainly hits it, doesn't he?
Oh, he can strike a ball. He's scored some great goals for Rangers over the years.
Here's Hamilton. McCann. No way past Gattuso that time. Salvatore. On the end of what was a poor ball from Gattuso. No obstruction on McCann. And did a good job there, Marino Gattuso, filling in at right back. Rangers having to reorganise for this game. There's so many players suspended and not quite fit. Ready, says the Rangers motto, but they're not quite ready at the moment for the big kickoff, and they're trailing hearts here at Tynecastle.
And so it all begins again. Wembley. Arsenal v Manchester United. The FA Charity Shield. Sunday at midday, live on Sky Sports 1.
My brother's a hero. Everybody loves him.
It takes 119.5 seconds to pour the perfect pint. Guinness. Good things come to those who wait.
Road rage. I used to get that. Every time I made a claim on my car insurance, all those phone calls and quotes. So angry, I sold the car.
Mate of mine, now he tells me, sorted his out with one phone call to Abbey National. One phone call.
Oi, watch it. You've made me bubble slightly from side to side.
You good little man.
I had an attack of river rage.
A balloon, I think.
Abbey National, because life's complicated enough.
Introducing an advanced painkiller for people who don't have time for pain. New Nurofen Advance. It's different because it has a specially developed formula. This speeds absorption into the body. It targets pain fast, so pain can't slow you down. New Nurofen Advance. Rapidly absorbed to target pain fast.
Because some soaps and shower gels can leave your skin feeling dry, you still have to use a body lotion. So can you enjoy soft-feeling skin after washing? Oil of Ulay solved the problem by adding 75% Ulay moisturiser to their first body wash system. Just this little on the puff cleans your whole body and moisturises your skin so intensively that your skin feels softer and smoother. Like the feel of a body lotion. And the name? Oil of Ulay Moisturising Body Wash. We can prove your skin can feel softer and smoother.
What you see is a car that combines drivability and dependability. It has pure looks and a body armour that lasts. Is checked to ensure it's as reliable as it is ingenious and is as economically beautiful as it is beautiful to behold. What you see is a Hyundai. So prepare to want one.
ever had football fantasies? Imagine your best 11. Who would they be? Get real. Choose 11 players and one manager worth $45 million and register your team with Sky Sports Interactive before live coverage commences on Sky Sports on August the 16th. Make all the right moves and you could win the £50,000 first prize. Sky Football Fantasia. Dream on.
Craig Moore. Jonas Turn. Rangers without the young midfielder Barry Ferguson, who was impressive against Shelbourne in the UEFA Cup in midweek. He's one of the many suspended. Kept Jonas Turn out of the side, in fact, in midweek. Here's Wallace. And Bronckhorst does get there, but unsurprisingly can't do much with it.
Yeah, there's not been a lot of fluency in the game so far, Ian. It's been a little bit drab, actually. There hasn't been a lot of action. I'd say possibly Hart scoring the goal, and then the best move has been Albert Strike across the face of the goal. But not a lot of great football so far.
Van Bronckhorst header. Swears header. Who's he going to drop for? McCann digging in to Turn. Rene Smith, young player of the year last season. Another of these tremendously talented Tynecastle youngsters.
Yeah, that's the one thing about Hearts. I think they won the Scottish League the Youth Cup a couple of years back, and the great thing from their point of view is there's so many young lads come into the first team now, and they're certainly reaping the reward.
Smith will be feeling the pressure though from Rob McKinnon, who's returned from Dutch football. He doesn't figure in the 16 on duty today. Oh, Jonas Turn was caught out then by Stefan Adam, and here's Hamilton. Will it be two? Oh, yes, it will! 2-0 to Hearts. Jim Hamilton. We wondered whether Rangers were ready. It would appear they are not, but Hearts most definitely are.
Brilliant finish. Tremendous finish of Hamill. I've got to admit, I feel a little bit sorry for Turn there. That's a great finish. He sticks it away well. To be fair to Jonas Turn, he looked up and he was wanting one of the forwards to show for him. And unfortunately, nobody showed for him. He was dispossessed, a great tackle, but it's a great finish. Perini goes for the first challenge. Hamilton evades him. And it's a wonderful strike with his left foot down the bottom. Name his left-hand corner. Great finish. Great finish.
There was a real buzz around the Hearts dressing room area before the game, and Jim Hamilton had one of the biggest smiles, cheeky little smile down there. And here they go again, with Hamilton once more, battered away, but only to Adam, and Naimi twice comes to Rangers' rescue as Hearts threaten to romp it.
I'll tell you what, Ian, to be honest with you, see if he doesn't hit it first time and puts McCann in. It's great football, wonderful football. I remember being a bit unfair on him. He's got to have a strike at goal there. But McCann was screaming down the left-hand side, he'd been in goal. Maybe a couple of good saves, a Ranger have been in serious trouble as opposed to just trouble.
It's Neil McCann with a vicious corner, which Naimi does well to cling on to.
Yeah, well, who would have thought? 30 minutes gone, or whatever, 25 minutes gone, Hearts winning 2-0. And deserving it.
Arthur Newman to Albert. Here's Newman, loves to go forward. The free kick goes against him. The man who was signed from PSV Eindhoven, he was captain under Dick Advocaat there.
I always find it interesting to know him when his big signing comes from the continent. You know, a lot of people think they're just over here for an easy ride. Well, if anybody thought they're over for an easy ride, 25 minutes into the opening game, I think they're not going to get one.
Salvatore's cross, Naimi comes for that. Well, Celtic dished out a warning yesterday. 5-0 hammering of Dunfermline. Hearts for so long last season, were right up there, just couldn't quite keep up with the pace in the title race towards the end. Jury's cross comes through to Alberts. Alberts teeing it up for Ian Ferguson. Magnificent tackle by Thomas Flogel. Here's Jury though. Now Rangers are starting to buzz, but there's been a couple of ones like that that have fizzed across the area.
That's right, they just need somebody to knock that ball right across the area in. But I think that was a strange decision by George Alberts here. I think when the ball broke him, initially his reaction was to hit it, and I think he should have hit it, but he tried to lay in the path of Ian Ferguson. But it was a good challenge, I think, by Salvatore, who got back one of the Hearts midfield.
Rino Gattuso, Ian Ferguson. Ferguson again to Alberts. Newman's going on the outside. Alberts goes inside to Jury. And here is Salvatore for Hearts, who have made a stunning start to the season. Volta. Salvatore. And he's looking to bring Flogel into it. And Craig Moore, to his credit, spotted the danger.
I tell you, Moore did pick up a well there, because Salvatore did brilliant. He sucked Newman in at about 5, 10 yards, and when he was on his way in, he played the ball right over his head. And thankfully for him, his point of view, that Craig Moore read the situation.
Gary Locke's throw finds the scorer of the second goal, Hamilton. And the corner kick goes the way of Hearts, much to the dismay of the Rangers fans near that linesman. It's not the best of Scottish League debuts for Arthur Newman at the moment. Hearts second corner, McCann and Fulton conspire. Here's McCann, and he'll get a free kick to be challenged by Turn.
Maybe see Hearts take the short corner. Yep, I think it's a free kick. Okay, Jonas Turn catches Neil McCann's right, left leg. I think it's a free kick. This could be dangerous.
More problems for Rangers then as Fulton gets ready to take the free kick, but just yet, Hugh Dallas wanting Van Bronckhorst to get back a bit. In comes Fulton's free kick, Neil McCann's header.
Ian, that's a chance, I tell you, because it's a great ball, but kind of a little bit of pace from Fulton. Turn misses it. McCann gets in front of his defender and possibly should have done better.
Well, Hearts and Rangers level as far as attempts at goal go, but that tells the real story. On target, 4 for Hearts, none so far for Rangers.
And as everybody says, Ian, the most important thing is hitting the target. You've got a chance if you hit the target.
To Capacan with plenty to think about. I think we'll see that pensive expression a few more times this afternoon, unless they can sort themselves out here. Andrei Kanchelskis having a laugh with the Hearts fans, but not many in the Rangers camp smiling at the moment. Kanchelskis on the bench, so to Gabriel Amato, the Argentinian striker. Another of the many big summer signings for Rangers is Alberts. Been there a couple of seasons now. Again, it's a dribble harmlessly through to Rousset.
From Hart's point of view, Ian, they're playing it very well, and thinks Jim Jeffries and Barry Brown must be delighted the way things are shaping up for them. I think from Rangers' point of view, they're obviously looking to be going to make changes at half-time with Chelsea's coming on. But it's a strange formation. I always feel Gordon Jury, when he plays through the middle himself, is a little bit isolated. And the most important thing, if you're playing one through the middle, you've got to get help to him, and Rangers aren't doing that at the moment.
Van Bronckhorst to Wallace. Back to Van Bronckhorst, who was in the Dutch World Cup squad, but couldn't figure. Mind you, they had a pretty good midfield as it was. He's only 23. Alberts to Jonas Turn. Jury let it go to Wallace. Salvatore with the interception. Here's Newman. Fouled by Stefan Adam. Quick free kick.
Gattuso. He was apparently linked with a possible move to Juventus recently. Jonas turns cross. Jury down for Van Bronckhorst. Rod Wallace with a great chance. And Rangers are back in the game. And Rod Wallace makes an immediate impact in Scottish football.
I don't want to say I told you so, but I'm going to say I told you so. It's amazing how many goals he had come from shots that are mishit. And here's another one. Gordon Jury leads into the path of Van Bronckhorst, who completely mishits his shot, and it's a great finish for Wallace. Rangers are back in the game. They're certainly getting goals today. Here you see, he completely miscues his shot. What does Wallace do? He comes in. The important thing, he hits the target, and you've got a chance, and he scores a good goal. Naismith, maybe just dilly-dallying a little bit, but be a bit of ball watching.
He's off the mark in his Rangers career, Rod Wallace. He wasn't even quite sure how far Edinburgh was from Glasgow when he looked at the fixture list and saw that it was Rangers' first game of the season. It would have taken him about an hour, he knows now. It's an enthralling encounter on the opening weekend of the new-look Scottish Premier League. Ian Ferguson. Lock and flow ball between them. Steer it away from Arthur Newman. Salvatore. Fulton. Naismith. Hearts are so comfortable on the ball. And here's McCann, he's in again. Neil McCann. And a superb tackle by Gattuso to deny Neil McCann and to deny Hearts a 3-1 lead.
I tell you what a tackle that is from Gattuso. How he gets back there, I'll never know. Oh, it's a wonderful tackle, because the big danger from his point of view is there, he gives away a penalty. But I was just going to say, and I've been very impressed with Adam so far. He's led the line very well, strong, quick, and he's on the end of that as well.
Well, it's Adam who takes the corners from this side. Away on the far post by Albert. It's not very far, it must be said. Rangers will dig it out eventually. Salvatore sends it back in. To no avail. Half an hour played. Hearts 2, Rangers 1. Moore's header will be chased by Jury. Ritchie gives him no chances. Playing it safe. Jury's quick throw and a push by Wallace on Naismith.
I'd say I'd like to see that one again, because Naismith did very well there. I think the foul might be another way, actually, but he did really well there, Naismith.
Kind of encouraged the push, didn't he?
Clever play, clever. Here we see it. Yeah, he does well there. I think Wallace was a bit surprised if he kept getting that way.
World Cup referee Hugh Dallas posing a few questions from the players. Albert has Newman for company, and here he is, away by Weir, but only to Gattuso, although the bounce is going to be very awkward for him. And McCann now finds Hamilton, and here go Hearts again, and Craig Moore has been given a yellow card for that challenge on McCann. And if he played the advantage then, they might have been away.
Ian, I tell you what, the referee didn't do it. I don't think he did Hearts any favours there. I mean, it's a foul and it's a booking, there's no doubt about it, but he can do it any time, he can pull them back after the chance. He can let, I think it was Hamilton come through here. I think there's no doubt about it, it was a foul and it was a booking, but at the same time, from Hart's point of view, I think they could have let him go.
Yes, I think Rangers might well settle for the free kick on that occasion, because they might have been in more trouble.
Absolutely.
So Craig Moore becomes the third man in this match to pick up a yellow card. Neil McCann back on his feet. A welcoming sight to Hearts fans. Not so to Rangers fans, though. Fulton's free kick. Hamilton's header. Adam and McCann both in there again, but it was shielded by Perini through to the keeper. Gattuso. Oh, Van Bronckhorst slipped at the most inopportune moment for him. Hamilton. They've been a joy to watch at times, Hearts. Some of their flowing football. Having said that, I thought they were just going to kick it out then. But they've given it away as it was. And another card is going to come out for the foul on Rob Wallace by Stevie Fulton. Won't be his only yellow card of the season, I dare say.
Yeah, it's just a late challenge, a daft kick on him there. Catches Wallace's right leg and leaves the referee with no alternative but to book him.
Some player, Steve Fulton, with a yellow card.
I think it's fair to say Stevie's best qualities are going forward. A bit like myself, he couldn't tackle a fish supper, we say.
Carini. And Weir's header will carry back to Rousseau. Ian Ferguson to Jonas Turn. Here's Gattuso. We've seen plenty of the ball in this first half. Between them, McCann and Naismith get Hearts out of trouble, but temporarily. Back in by Wallace. It's going to be another Rangers corner as Thomas Flogel knocks it behind.
Yeah, it seems as though Alberts has taken a few corners over here on the Rangers left.
Alberts in again. It's through to McCann. Now, could there be a break on here? Gattuso ensures that there isn't. Newman, who was covering there. The defender's sent up for the corner. Alberts. Newman. Wallace, Newman again. This is nice from Rangers, but the interception was from Ritchie.
One pass away from being brilliant.
Ian Ferguson. Jury going into the channel. Certainly from the corner. And the tussle with David Weir.
That was a great tussle there watching the two of them. They're both equally determined. Here's a great angle of it. And Jury does well. I mean, they both do well there because Weir gets a header and Jury does well to get his body across him and get the corner.
Alberts' corner. And it's a goal kick this time. So Rangers' first foreign coach, Dick Advocaat, saw his side go 2-0 down. But Rangers coming back into it and giving the Hearts manager, Jim Jeffries, a little bit of concern. But it's been a fantastic first half. From one number five to another, Newman to Salvatore, Flogel, Lock, here's Perini. Ian Ferguson, Craig Moore. In first half injury time, that was straight at Fulton. And back to Fulton from McCann. That's about the first time it didn't really go right for McCann as it trickled through his legs. Here's Alberts. Van Bronckhorst. Weir is with him, and it cannoned off him, away by Salvatore. Here's Alberts. Well, it's going to come through to Van Bronckhorst from Fulton's tackle. Van Bronckhorst within inches of levelling it for Rangers.
Beautiful straight with the left foot there, wasn't it? Here we see it. A little bit of luck in the respect that goes through Locke's legs, but that's a superb effort. Not sure where the keeper had that covered, you know.
Well, it's half time at Tynecastle. Stefan Adam put Hearts into the lead. Jim Hamilton doubled that lead. Rangers looked in real trouble, but Rod Wallace hauled them back into the game. Stefan Adam poaching. And the second strike was from Jim Hamilton as Jonas Thurn got caught in possession. Another clinical finish from Hamilton. There were plenty of them last season as well, delighting Jim Jeffries and co. Top scorer last season, off the mark this season. But Rod Wallace, as Van Bronckhorst appeared to miscue it, Rod Wallace pounced. And that could turn out to be a really key goal for Rangers. But the Hearts fans have loved what they've seen so far. We trust you have as well. We trust we've whetted your appetite for the Scottish Premier League season. Half time, Hearts 2, Rangers 1.
Good news for Sky satellite customers.
These days, value for money is more important than ever.
To bring you the best value, we're freezing the price of our most popular packages for 12 months.
Quality and service are so important and so easily forgotten.
We promise to bring you the best channels available.
Life's all about variety. We all want choice. It keeps us entertained.
We promise to bring you the widest choice of television you want to watch.
Ah, stood up again. Next time, I should get it in writing.
Every Sky satellite customer will be receiving with their August TV guide, the Sky Customer Promise, outlining our commitment to bring the best value, quality and choice into your home. All you need is Sky.
Yes, Mrs. Shipley?
You don't know where Bournemouth and Wrexham are doing, do you?
Good!
There is now a brand new football game.
Wigan 3, Macclesfield 3.
And it kicks off with a £2 million jackpot. Buy a £1 match ticket from any national lottery machine and you'll receive 11 randomly chosen matches.
Gunthorpe, Mansfield. What do you reckon, Sydney?
If eight of your matches are score draws, you could be one of our jackpot winners.
One, Dumbarton, one.
Saturdays will never be the same. Vernon's Easy Play. Every week, it's a whole new ball game.
Rolexa remote-controlled garage doors. Luxury and convenience at affordable prices. The automatic garage door and window system that extends the security of your home. Phone now for your free brochure on 0800 018 4499 because this summer we have a special offer to provide you with even lower prices. On all orders fitted before the 31st of August, we're offering a free garage door remote control system with handset. So phone now for your free brochure on 0800 018 4499. That's 0800 018 4499. Don't miss this very special offer.
No. No.
Ah! Horrible!
This looks like a job for...
Blast Joe with bleach.
Like a cream, it clings to stains, but unlike a cream...
It cleans with hardly any effort.
And the bleach makes sure it's all hygienically clean.
Oh, my hair.
It's a tough job.
But someone's got to.
Blast Joe with bleach does the hard work, so you don't have to.
You've been to some nice places.
Yes, I have. Singapore is terrific.
That's Prime Minister something.
You see that?
Scary.
Fatima, big star. 52 countries in 2 years.
This new software I've installed, it's gonna save your life. It's called Lotus Notes.
Let you collaborate on projects all over the world.
You never have to leave the office. It's gonna be great to have you around.
Road rage. I used to get that. Every time I made a claim on my car insurance, all those phone calls and quotes. So angry, I sold the car.
Mate of mine, now he tells me, sorted his out with one phone call to Abbey National. One phone call.
Hey, what's it? You've made me wobble slightly from side to side.
You've
got this on that. I had an attack of river rage.
Hot air balloon, I think.
Abbey National. Because life's complicated enough.
Anyone for cricket?
That's beautifully timed.
It's the one day game that's a little different. Because when the sun goes down, the lights go on. AXA League day-night cricket.
Bowled in.
Limited overs, unlimited excitement. It's cricket in the twilight zone. You'll be hooked.
That's got it.
An AXA League cricket double. Today and Wednesday at 5, exclusively live on Sky Sports 1.
As Hearts prepare to start the second half with a 2-1 lead.
The most interesting fact at half-time there, even without a doubt, was Jim White's comments about cricket there. I know Jim's a big cricket fan. You can write down what he knows about cricket in the back of a stamp, Ian. Take it from me. In capital letters, by the way.
And Chelsea is immediately trying to get in on the act. He did manage to win a cricket match in Scotland.
We said, I don't know what it says about the opposition. That's a bit unfair. Our lads do okay.
Gattuso with the Rangers throw. David Weir, firm header clear. Now by Parini on Adam.
Yeah, but it just looks as though they've made the switch as we thought, Ian. They've put Kinchelskis wide on the right. They brought Alberts in the infield, in the middle of the midfield with Ferguson. And Van Bronckhorst is going wider left. Wallace pushed through the middle with Jury.
Hamilton down to Adam. Rangers seemingly a bit slow to react, but they get there in the end.
I think it's an emotional game. I think he's got every right to show his emotion. It is an emotional game.
Absolutely. Here's Alberts. Low ball to Fulton. Here's Gary Naismith. He's got Gattuso to contend with. Another tackle by Gattuso, although it runs through to McCann. Oh, superb from Neil McCann. Still he goes, and he's just trying to do a little bit too much, and it bobbled away from him.
It was absolute magic from McCann, it really was. And I feel it's a shame for me to try here and criticise him, but he's touched his let him down a little bit at the minute there, because I think basically got caught in two minds. I think he was going to have a strike for goal, and then I think at the last minute he was going to square it. But it was a wonderful skill there. He does Moore nice as you like, looks up, looks at the goalie, and I think he just takes it. The ball comes off his right foot there, as you see. Goalkeeper again, give him a bit of credit, it's a good stop.
Here's Jury, and that one squeezed in by Gordon Jury, just wide of the target.
Good strike again, Gordon Jury here. Takes onto his right foot, away from Locke, and that isn't far away. I think the goalkeeper might have a bit covered, to be fair to him, but it's a good strike, keeps it down well. I think the goalie might just have a bit covered.
Well, the chances coming thick and fast. To Hamilton at the moment. Jim Jeffries and Billy Brown, what might they be saying, Jürgen?
Well, I think they'll be quite happy so far. I don't think there's any doubt about that. Hearts have certainly created the better chances. I think we saw the figures in the first half, the Rangers had the bulk of possession, but that doesn't go for anything. It's about chances and about taking them. That's the most important thing about football. And Hearts, to their credit, have created the better chances and have stuck two of them away.
Salvatore, Newman, rather firm back pass to Naimi. Gattuso leaves it for Alberts. This is Van Bronckhorst. And Wallace tries the spectacular from Rod Wallace.
Well, that was certainly spectacular. It was a good move from Rangers again with Alberts. Gattuso initially starting and giving the ball to Alberts, releasing the ball to Van Bronckhorst down the left-hand side here. And it's a good ball in, just above Weir. And it was an acrobatic effort, and had that gone in, I'd have just walked off.
Tried a few of them yourself?
Yeah, and I ended up in hospital after them.
Here's Gary Naismith. In he goes. This is some run. And he finds a goal offside. Flag is up. It wouldn't have counted anyway. Offside flag against Stefan Adam.
Yeah, it was good to watch that, actually. It was a good through ball. But there, Newman, the key man here is Newman. Newman does superbly well. He holds his line, and he knows for a fact that Adam has got to get into that hole, and it's offside.
Here's Wallace. Kanchelskis hasn't seen much of the ball now, but he will do. And here he is. Kanchelskis with a cross, flicked on by Wallace, who's showing off a few skills.
I would have killed myself laughing if Kanchelskis had scored there, so I would. He had a bit of magic on the right-hand side. Wallace tries to flick it, and it goes through his legs. And it's all about gambling in there again.
The cross from Kanchelskis, back by Van Bronckhorst. And Hearts went to sleep then and looked around for flags, which I think the linesman has signalled something, has he?
I don't know what the linesman's given there. I mean, that's a corner. There's no doubt about it. It's a corner, and he's decided he's given a... he's given a corner. He's made the correct decision. I think initially, to be fair to the referee, he thought the linesman might have been given offside, but he's correctly made the reverse of the decision.
Yes, Hugh Dallas says corner kick to Rangers. Here's Albert. And Craig Moore, he had a free header, but couldn't get it on target, and perhaps should have done.
Yeah, I think you're right. He does well initially. Makes a good run, gets in front of his marker, gets up well. Oh, that's a wonderful picture, that. And his header, you can see, goes 3 or 4 yards off target. But he certainly got well. But once again, we see the real quality from Albert's taking corners and free kicks as such. And if you've got quality like that, you've always got a chance.
Approaching the hour mark, the three goals in this game coming in the first half. Wallace took a kick from Fulton then. And the referee will have to stop play so that Rob Wallace can get a little bit of treatment.
Yeah, you see him. But once again, it's great camera work, because basically Fulton, look at him, doesn't take his eye off the ball. There's nothing malicious in that at all. He doesn't see Wallace. And unfortunately for the wee man, he just catches him. To be fair, you wouldn't have to lift your leg very high to catch Rob Wallace, would you? I nearly got that right.
Greg Moore with the free kick. Rangers looking for a leveller. And Broncos wasn't quite sure where that one bounced. Arthur Newman. Here's Wallace. 1-2 with Jury. Didn't quite take the ball with him, Rob Wallace, but it was a close one.
Yeah, that little bit of football was certainly encouraging. It's nice to see the front two lines linking together, and they certainly did on that occasion.
Ritchie's clearance goes straight to Newman, who finds his fellow Dutchman Van Bronckhorst, but that one's straight into the arms of Russo.
Yeah, I think that the game so far, especially the second half, I think once again Rangers, like the first half, had the bulk of possession. They've looked good, they've created one or two nice moves. But I still feel that Hearts have got the cutting edge, and I still think Hearts look more dangerous team to score.
Hamilton's flick on. Adam trying to find a way through. Gattuso steps into the situation. Thomas Vlogel. Being hassled by Newman. Ian Ferguson. And there's space here for Kanchelskis and co. to exploit. He's got Gattuso to his right. He might not use anyone, Kanchelskis. Trying to run through the Hearts defence. And by Ian Ferguson.
Yeah, just going back, that was a chance for Rangers, but at one point there it was 4-3. And here's a challenge for Ian Ferguson. Yep, catches Jim Hamilton left leg there. Don't think there's any doubt that was a free kick.
Be taken by Gary Naismith. Craig Moore will let that one run. Jim Jeffries, the manager of Hearts, I tell you what, he must have one heck of a sore throat after every game.
He's certainly passionate about his football as well, Jim, isn't he?
Salvatore. Neil McCann. Hamilton. McCann. Gattuso. He doesn't really want to give it back to McCann. The free kick has been given. The way of hearts. What a battle between those two, though.
It really is. It's good to watch, I must admit. Gattuso, I think, tried to put it inside to Moore, but McCann, if nothing, he's persistent, I'll tell you. And he gets the free kick there. But you see, the whistle's gone about 3 seconds before that. The two of them are oblivious to it.
That is carrying on merrily. It's Fulton with a free kick. And a comfortable catch for Naimi and a decent throw out as well. Here goes Jury. Salvatore coming across with him. And Jury has run that out of play. It'll be a hard throw. Much to the delight of the home fans.
Yeah, Salvatore did really well matching Gordon Jury's run there, because Gordon Jury's a very powerful runner, there's no doubt about that. But Salvatore matched him well.
Richie's header. Albert's header. Ferguson's header. Here's Kanchelskis. Kanchelskis might latch onto this. No, Paul Richie will get there first. 22 years of age, played for Scotland's B side last season. Gattuso to Wallace, back again. Patient stuff from Rangers. Here's Gattuso, Wallace. Ian Ferguson, Wallace, under pressure from Richie. Really have been some tremendous tussles between individual players in this game. Gabriel Amato, the Argentinian striker, is ready to make an appearance. Signed from Real Mallorca of Spain. Ferguson with the overhead kick. Wallace with a header, and it's going to come back to Ian Ferguson! Lashed across the face of goal, and Jury, unable to make contact, came across very fiercely.
Yeah, it was a chance. He opened his body up and tries to hit it outside his right foot in front of Gordon Jury. But I think Ian Ferguson is probably having one of his best games in a while for Rangers. I think he's played very well today. One or two good performances, centre back, some hearts as well. But the game's still pretty open, and Emdy could win it.
Gabriel Amato is on for Gio van Bronckhorst. Rangers make another change. One thing was certain, when Amato and Kanchelskis were named as substitutes, it was certain that we would see them at some stage. Neither of them fully match fit at the moment. Craig Moore. It's going to dribble away from Kanchelskis.
It's interesting to see how they've reacted to the change. It looks as though Gordon Jury's dropped a little bit left-hand side here.
Alberts was looking for him, Jury, didn't find him. Rangers still have it. Amato gets his first touch. 18 goals for Mallorca last season. His first touch didn't last very long. But then it's given away by Flogel to Gattuso. Wallace. Kanchelskis. Kanchelskis to Gattuso. Moore. Ferguson to Albert. Newman advancing down the left-hand side, and he gets the corner kick off Gary Locke. Doesn't look the most happiest person in time, Carson.
No, he doesn't. But you have to say that Rangers have the bulk of the possession again here, and they're playing some good football. but failing to get any shots on goal.
Alberts with the corner. Away by Fulton, but only to Ian Ferguson. And a decent cross from him, and Wallace sneaked in with the header as Craig Moore knocked it down. Goal kick.
That was a great header from Craig Moore. He got, I think it was David Weary got up the ball. Can you see it? Good through ball. Yeah, it's a great header. And Wallace a little bit unlucky, trying to get on the end of it.
Midway point of the second half. Hearts leading by 2-1. All the goals came in the first half. Gabriel Amato, 18 goals for Mallorca last season, 13 of them in the Spanish top flight, 5 of them in the cup. In fact, Mallorca got to the cup final, he helped them get there. Fulton. Hamilton. A smile never far from Jim Hamilton's face. Second half action areas. And as you can see, it's very much shaded by Rangers.
In the country's largest league, no game means more. No rivalry greater. No goal more treasured. Where the future is nurtured and the boot deal is you earn your stripes. The heart and soul of football. A new season of the Nationwide League. Grimsby v Ipswich Town, Sunday 3:30, Sky Sports 2.
This could happen to you unless you eat new Starburst Juicers. Colourful shells that burst in your mouth and release real fruit flavour like you've never tasted before. Give it some juice!
Oh no, how are we going to sort this lot out?
Don't worry, Mr. Jones.
All these other insurance companies.
We'll do all that.
I'll have to take a day off going around garages getting estimates.
No, leave that to us.
But we still have to get it picked up.
No, we'll get it picked up. No problem.
When do we have to come and get it?
Don't worry, we'll deliver it back for you. I wonder if it'll be cleaned inside and out and looking like new.
Well, it certainly looks good.
It's better than that, Mr. Jones. All the work is covered by a 3-year guarantee.
For easy, low-cost motor insurance.
Better talk direct to Direct Line.
Bell's Whiskey. Every drop aged 8 years.
Can't door banana ice cream. Real banana pieces in real banana ice cream. Leaves only one thing on your mind. Wish I had a bigger spoon.
The Grim Tooth Fairy Tales.
I've been a tooth fairy. In the past, all I had to worry about was toothbrushes. But now you people are using something else after you've brushed your teeth. Oh no, not another bottle!
Listerine kills more harmful bacteria than brushing alone, giving you healthier teeth and gums.
These are rock solid! Oi! I go next door, mate! They're using Listerine night and day!
When brushing starts, Listerine finishes.
Look there. If you look that side. Oh, that's beautiful. It's kind of slanted.
I know, but don't worry about that.
Conventional oil cannot protect properly until it reaches a critical temperature. Remember, this is when 75% of engine wear occurs. How long can it take to reach this temperature? 10 minutes. Your oil is just getting started, but your journey could have finished. Even when cold, Magnatec has unique polarized molecules which cling like a magnet, protecting from the moment you turn the key. Hit GTX Magnatec from Castrol.
In a world of tough decisions,
never gonna make it.
One simple action
open the bar.
Can mean success.
Running out of time.
Beyond your wildest dreams.
Good to have you with us.
The first account. It will change your life forever.
The new look Sky TV Guide. More fun, more value from your TV. Get the hot news from the world of entertainment with Barry Norman. Britain's best-known film critic is coming to Sky. A new, improved, colour-coded system helps you easily find what you want to watch. Flip the magazine over to find Sky TV Sports, a new dedicated sports guide. This month, an exclusive on Dennis Bergkamp, the Sky TV Guide, designed with you in mind.
Well, I think credit to Hearts second half as well. I think they defended fairly well. As I've said earlier at the start of the game, a big fan of their two centre-backs. I think they've had equally good cover from their full-backs. I think they defended fairly well.
And there's one of them, Richie. Andy McCann, who looks like he's ready to run again, but that will be an offside against Stefan Adam. He just didn't get back in time.
Yeah, it's interesting to note there that if Adam gets out the road, McCann can possibly go through himself. But once he starts and his interference with the pass, it is offside.
Newman, Alberts. As Rangers look to try and square it up. And the free kick has gone Alberts' way, having his shirt tugged. Now Gary Locke, who had plenty to say to Hugh Dallas about it. Alberts then to whip this free kick in. In the end, he floats it in. Corner kick and a good header by Hamilton.
Yeah, I think Jim Hamilton actually headed that over his own crossbar. Here we see the free kick from Alberts again. Goalkeeper in two minds, and he does, he knocks. He might have been getting fouled there, to be fair to him. But the initial foul on Alberts was a strange decision. I think Gary Lockford every right to feel a little bit aggrieved there.
Here comes the corner kick from Alberts. Jury at the near post, so was Richie. And Adam beats Newman to it. Thomas Flogel. Here's Fulton, Hearts have plenty of options forward here, but Fulton wastes what might have been a decent opportunity.
Yeah, what killed it there, Ian, there's no doubt about it, the extra touch Fulton takes, because it's a wonderful run from Adam, and he's through the middle, and once Fulton takes the touch, he's got to hold up his run, and the whole momentum of the move's lost.
Here's Ian Ferguson. Kanchelskis hoping to make much of an impact on this game, which of course means he'll go and score in a moment. Gattuso to Wallace. Kanchelskis.
Then again, Ian, when Wallace gets the ball there, I think he had the opportunity to be a little bit more direct. He does give a good ball to Kanchelskis. Bowers feel that if he runs at the left fullback, he can commit him and put him out of the game and make it easier for Kanchelskis.
Why Hamilton is needing treatment. He's been in the wars a bit in this game, actually. And he felt that one, Jim Hamilton. Francesca's yeah. Came in.
I think you just seen both players totally committed and going for the ball there. And Jim, unfortunately, took a little bit of a knock.
Jim Jeffries, the Hearts manager, guided them to glory in the Scottish Cup final with victory against Rangers. But as we said, they didn't beat them in the league at all last season, only took 1 point out of a possible 12 off them. Well, they could already be about to improve on that tally. They're 2-1 up inside the final quarter of an hour. Alberts. Jury's header. Amato won't come down for him. Away by McCann, who felt the force of Gattuso right in his back then. And it's time for Alan Ray, the physio, to be called upon again.
It's a strange looking one, and it doesn't look an awful lot in it. But with the back, you've got to be very, very careful. And it could be a lot more serious than it looks. It doesn't look an awful lot in it, Ian, but you never know with the back. Thankfully, it looks as though he's getting back on his feet.
Neil McCann Does indeed rise to his feet for a round of applause. Here's Rod Wallace. Gattuso is with him. And here he is. Ian Ferguson. Jury will go for this one, but so will Russo. Gary Locke. Albert ready to take the Rangers throw. Ian Ferguson. Craig Moore. And it's trickling all the way through, and oh, it's still bubbling around, and McCann in the end is going to get it away. He's passed off it by Jury. Here's Gordon Jury. McCann recovered to get an excellent tackle in, and Albert, just as he was about to unleash one, it was whipped away from him, but excitement aplenty in the Hearts penalty area.
What was that all about in there? That was like the Keystone Cops at Tynecastle, wasn't it? There was everything going on there.
Here they go again, as Wallace looks for Kanchelskis, and the timely tackle comes from Paul Ritchie. Here's Perini, Newman. Gabriel Amato, tackled by Flogel in the end. David Weir was doing his bit as well, wrestling with Amato. Here's Newman. Here's Jury. Gattuso. Kanchelskis. Here's Albert. Rangers are camped inside the Hearts half at the moment. Perini to Jury. Newman. Excellent tackle by Thomas Flogel. Hamilton's away, and so is Adam. And well, the flag, it didn't go up then against Adam.
No, it was very close. Now, obviously, we've got hindsight and replays and such, but I don't think that the linesman got it right there. I think he was just offside. But it's certainly a good score from Jim Hamilton.
Now, what about that flurry of activity in the half penalty area?
Here we are. I don't know what that was all about. Certainly a bit of a mix-up there. But certainly, I think the second half Rangers, that's a good move here. Newman knocks it across here. The goalkeeper comes, it kicks it out. And then Jury gets a break of the ball again here.
It was comedy time. Ooh, the thumping drive from Albert. Newman is in there, and Russo recovers.
Great strike. What a wonderful strike of the ball that was. A good save too.
That was a real killer driller from the man they call the Hammer, Albert.
Here we see it again, Jury involved. Well, that's a some strike. And thankfully for Hearts, he goes straight at the goalkeeper.
Who then recovered to make another save, Russo. Well, he conceded 13 goals in four meetings against Rangers last season, but just the one so far in the opening game of this season. So he's improving on his average of letting in three against Rangers. But what a strike this was from Albert. How many times have we seen him do that?
I think you saw there, Russo has played against Albert enough that he doesn't even attempt to catch them. He just gets them away with any part of his body.
Stung his palms, that one. Here's Wallace. Ferguson. Another stray pass from Ian Ferguson that time.
Yeah, I think Rangers are just getting a little bit worried and concerned that they haven't got this equalising goal. I think it's be a cruel man that would say they haven't deserved it in their second half performance. I think they have, but at the same time, it's all about putting the ball in the back of the net.
Perini. Ferguson. Gattuso has worked hard as usual for Rangers. In that right back role. Albert. Fulton and McCann between them. Can clear ranks. Foul by Moore on Adam.
It's good play from the forward. He just backs in and uses his body very well. Forces the referee into giving a foul.
Done that a few times, I bet.
There's plenty more of me than him as well, I tell you.
Naismith with a free kick for Hearts, leading Rangers by 2-1. But they've been under a bit of pressure. It's going to be a frantic final 5 minutes at Tynecastle. Albert, Jury, and Jury, and it's battered away by Rousset, and Rangers are coming closer and closer.
Yeah, you almost feel it's inevitable. Albert's involved again, releases Jury. He takes a touch, and it's a good strike with his left foot, which you're going to see as well.
In comes Albert's corner. Amato's off target, though, and Hearts will be rather glad about that.
Yeah, as I said earlier, I think Hearts have defended fairly well. I think they've handled the Rangers front lads quite well. Here we see the corner coming in. Amato gets on the end of it, it's not a real threat. But they've handled the Rangers front lads fairly well. And Albert's coming from midfield. Further they can hang on to this result, they need to be seen.
Stefan Adam gets a rousing reception from the Tynecastle faithful. Adam, the French striker, replaced by Grant Murray. Here's Newman. Newman with the up and under. Here's McCann. Flogel facing a chase to keep it in. He'll just get there, but then Gordon Jury came in. Throw into Hearts, though, and they'll settle for that as this game reaches its climax. Celtic and Aberdeen off to winning starts this weekend. So to Kilmarnock and Motherwell, will Hearts join the group of winning teams on the weekend of the big kickoff? Here's Fulton. Craig Moore finds Kanchelskis. You wouldn't bet against a Rangers equaliser, though. But what magnificent work by Naismith to whip it off the toes of Kanchelskis. And in turn, find McCann. And McCann now to Hamilton. Oh, not quite that time for Hamilton, who scored Hart's second goal.
It's certainly end-to-end stuff. And Naismith had a fantastic tackle. And Kanchelskis at one end and is a superb ball to McCann. Good ball into the path of Hamilton. He decorates the stand with it.
Here's Craig Moore. That was poor, straight to Flogel. Flogel. Gary Locke. Cannoned off Perini. And it fell rather kindly for Thomas Flogel. Onto his left foot. Just over from the Austrian.
Great skill there. Creates a little bit of space for himself. Wonderful, gets us a half yard, which is all you need. Always get over, but it's a good effort.
Craig Moore to Perini. Rangers have got to think now about getting it forward as we head towards the final minute of normal time. Perini. Here's Fulton. And Hearts, you can be sure now, will just try and hang on to it, but almost failed to do so. Handball given against Locke. Wallace now. Albert. Gattuso couldn't quite control it. Or could Hamilton. Some of the Hearts fans whistling already. Albert looking for Newman, who goes in round the back and just couldn't quite get there. Goal kick given. Flogel it was who tracked back with him.
Yeah, it was good defending there from Flogel. He matched his man and matched Newman's run well.
Now, what about a man of the match, Ali?
Well, it's been some good individual performances. I think Ian Ferguson's played well for Rangers. I think the Hearts' two centre-backs, Weir and Ritchie, have played well. But I'm going for the man who's just been substituted. And I hasten to add, I've made my decision even after he's been substituted. Stefan Adam, I think his first half performance was out of this world. And I think he worked hard second half, and he's got my man in the match.
That's a fine showing from Stefan Adam. Scored Hearts' first goal as well. That was rather hurriedly cleared away by David Weir, who says he did not hear the shout from Rousse. You can't blame him in this atmosphere. Jury getting ready for a long throw. As Rangers look for an injury time equaliser to salvage a point. Hearts have only won 5 of the last 37 meetings with Rangers. It will be a major opening weekend coup for them if they can hang on. Jury's cross will fall through to Rousse, and he won't be a man in a hurry. Will Rousse take out the car? Launching a new era for a new look Rangers, but it looks like it's going to start in defeat. David Weir onside McCann. Kept it in play, but it'll go behind for a goal kick. And there's no time for niceties now. Rangers have simply got to lump it upfield. Gattuso. Jury. Newman. Ian Ferguson. They're going to have to get it into the box. Ferguson does just that. And the Hearts will happily watch that one go behind for a goal kick. And Hearts move ever closer. Jim Jeffrey's side moving ever closer to 3 points.
I think you see him there encouraging his lads, telling us only about a couple of minutes to go. Just a little bit of concentration. Looks as though Hearts will be picking up the first 3 points.
Minute of injury time play. There can't be many more to go. Although the Hearts physio has been a busy man at times this afternoon. A big kick forward. Here's Salvatore. Fulton. Maybe Hearts will go looking for a third goal. That's a magnificent ball from Fulton to McCann. There goes McCann. Hamilton is in the middle. But it's the keeper, Naimi, who gets there.
Yeah, a great run again, left-hand save from McCann. I just felt Hamilton could have been a little bit more direct and helped him out.
Here's Albert. David Weir stops Albert in his tracks, and Hearts have beaten Rangers by 2-1, just as they did in the Scottish Cup final in May. But this is vital, because they never managed to beat Rangers in the league last season. They've done it already this season. And that could be telling. That could mean they're ready to challenge Glasgow's domination of this famous country's championship.
So, Hearts have given an early warning that they'll be a force to be reckoned with in the race for the first Scottish Premier League title. Join us on Tuesday night at 6:30 on Sky Sports 1 for the first edition of Inside Scottish Football, where you'll find all the latest news from the Scottish game. Hope you enjoyed the curtain raiser to the new season. Bye for now.